All right, everybody, welcome back to Kremin Incorporated. If you are at this video, you're probably looking for some information on Citizen Swiss lathes. I'm gonna give you my review on the Citizen's L32. All right, we have a wide variety of different model Swiss lathes here at Kremin Inc. Not one, not two, not three, not four, but five different models of Citizen Swiss lathes. The L32 Type 12 is one of our most productive Swiss lathes. The machine takes 32 millimeter diameter material. It's got a plethora of tooling positions, both on the backside with double roll holders, the gang, as well as the subspindle. What makes this machine unique to us and one of the most productive is the B-axis arm. That arm is live and programmed on the fly. We can rotate it at almost any angle, up to just past 90 degrees, to allow us to work on the part, live milling, cutting, whatever we need to do on that backside arm. So it's been a fantastic machine to run highly complicated parts, lights out, at very precise tolerances. Couple things to watch out for with this machine. The bar loader system is integrated into the main control panel, which is a nice addition. However, we've had problems with our three L32s loading 32 millimeter bars of stock automatically. Seems to be some kind of design issue with the machine that the bar collet loader actually interferes with the casting of the machine. If you're considering one of these, you're gonna wanna make sure you talk to your Citizen's rep to see if they've got that issue taken care of. Otherwise, you're gonna have to find a workaround like we have to do. We either have to cut bar ends down or single load bars to make it run the large diameter material. Definitely something you wanna look out for. Another issue to be aware of.
Oh, I'm sorry, did I break your concentration?
Another issue to be aware of that's really across the board with our Swiss lathes is coolant flow and low coolant alarms. We take a lot of pride in running our machines lights out, and the number one issue we come into if there was a failure with the lights out operation is a low coolant alarm. Ironically, it doesn't really have anything to do with the amount of coolant in the machine. There's plenty of coolant. It's got to do with the flow of that coolant and the amount of chips that build up. Chips build up into this system so much that it doesn't allow the coolant to get back in and through the system to register that it's full, so it alarms the machine out. So we spend a lot of time cleaning these out. So much so, sometimes we gotta get Trevor in there with his toy shovel to get really down and dirty to clean these out so they keep running. So maintenance of this system is really important for lights out operation. All right guys, all in all, I'd give this machine a 4 out of 5 stars. It's a fantastic production machine for us, but it has some minor quirks you need to be aware of. Be sure to check on large diameter stock. It's gonna run through for you. Be sure to manage your chip flow. Make sure that's taken care of so it can keep it running on those unattended operations. I'll take you through the rest of our Swiss lathes in future videos. Be sure to like and subscribe. Put a comment in if you got questions. See you next time.